please come up on stage and hand over a token of appreciation to Mr. John Ibrahim. Welcome back, is what we'd like to tell you. So I had the pleasure of meeting them before, so that's why welcome back. We are here today and just another week to go. So what are
we've really enjoyed doing this film, and we are really anxious and wanting the film to release on the 4th of September, and fingers crossed, we really enjoyed doing the film, and I hope all of you all and the people also enjoyed as much. You know, it's a very cliched way to say it, but this genuinely, I feel, you're going to enjoy the film.
Well, I feel this is one film that, which Anil sir also said, it's a film that people would find very difficult to critique. It's like he says, it's the most cliche saying, but leave your brains behind and come and enjoy this film, because if you put on the news, there is only bad news. Everything seems so heavy. If you've been watching films of late, with no disrespect, but they're all very heavy films. And, you know, if you just want to take your family out and just have a smile, have a good time, feel happy, and at the same time, not be embarrassed about taking your nephew or niece or your grandparents out, then Welcome Back is a perfect family film, because it has no bad language, it has no exposure, it has no double meaning, it has no bloodshed. You even love your villain. You know, Wanted Bhai is the most lovable villain that you can get in this side of town. So it's an absolute fun film, and please be rest assured that the genius is in the writing, and all credit to Mr. Anees Bazmi for having written and directed such a fun and a happy film. Very happy film. That's all I can say. Like Anil sir said, we're not here to make great cinema. We're here to make entertaining cinema. We want to make a fun film and a very, very happy film. We want everyone to be happy. There are problems everywhere in this world, in this country. Everyone should go in for 2 hours, 15 minutes and be happy.
So I think we can rightly say that let's welcome back smiles.
This is just the beginning of a glorious future for, you know, Reliance Rescue and for GeoChat, which we just did. That's the future of our country and of the world. That's what I can say. And this tour is absolutely terrific, fantastic. This is the first time I've come here. And, I thought I was somewhere in New York or, London. You know, this is as good as that.
Well, Nikhil Bhai is not here, but I'd like to thank him. He's a close friend and he works with Reliance. And, I'd like to wish all the people at GeoChat all the very best. Reliance Digital is hemmed by, of course, Mr. Mukesh Dhirubhai Ambani, and he's a man with a vision. And Brian sitting around here, I can't see Brian anywhere around here, but they've got a great team, they're very aggressive, and I wish with our products aggressively enough so that it reaches out to everyone here, and everyone would like to go and pick up something and say, hey, it's affordable.
So Anil, so which is your favorite gadget? It's very difficult to pick gadgets these days. We have a lot of new and wide range of options which are obviously available here, but which is your favorite gadget?
See, at the moment, my favorite gadget is my phone, to be honest with you. That's my, it's a phone which I, which I'm using, and that's my favorite phone. And the exciting part is that I've got a very good juicer with my phone, and the juicer really looks sexy, so I like it.
Yeah. Fantastic. So John, if you had to gift an electronic or digital item to somebody, what is it one product that you would give somebody?
I mean, today in the world of social networking, everybody wants a smartphone, and you'd probably want to give one of those. But if I really had to gift somebody something, I mean, look at the options here. There are a million options here. I'd actually give something pretty strange. I'd give them earphones so they can wear it on the treadmill and run.
Fantastic.
Answered everything, so I don't think there's anybody. There is someone who's a.
One question I would like to ask you all. school and college, one lesson which you guys have learned outside from your school or college and from home?
Respect our elders, you know, and teachers, or you can call them gurus, and you know, if at home our parents are there, and in wherever we, you know, study, they are almost like our parents, and that's what I've learned, you know.
I believe teachers, just like your parents, are probably the most important influencing factors in your life. And my teachers have, I remember all my teachers, and I miss and I love all of them. And Jai Hind College, I miss my teachers from there too. And I remember each one of them very, very fondly, and my respect and my love goes out to each one of them. And that's what all youngsters should do. Respect the elders, respect the teachers as much as they respect their parents, and you'll have a great future, because education is the way forward.
So John, my question is,
always that problem hota rehta, and then I'm out for 2 days. Lekin abhi theek hai, thank you.
So, but a question to both of you, is it not tiring to walk even on Raksha Bandhan, because our sisters have been waiting at home saying that abhi aayenge Raksha Bandhan ki rakhi bandhwane?
See, for me, working on a holiday, and especially festivals, is the best thing. I feel I'm blessed. I'm blessed because I have always tried, like, especially on Holi. It's been many, you know, I've been in this business, show business, and in this profession since many years. And I see to it that I work on Holi also. So, you know, I feel it's, I think somewhere my sister has blessed me, who's in Delhi, and she sends me her good wishes. And she always says, I want you to keep on working. You know, so I think it's the best thing. That's the best thing she could say, because I love working, and I would love to work on every Raksha Bandhan day and remember my sister.
John, your take?
I personally, I mean, I don't believe in holidays, but that's a very extremist way of looking at things, and it's very unfair. But yeah, I don't really believe in holidays at all. I think we've got too many holidays in this country.